Hello there everyone, and welcome back to another painting stream with me, Bachikolia. And today, hopefully we'll be able to finish up base coating of our two Norse ladies. Hopefully. Put the camera a little bit down. Yep. Again, here's hoping today I will choose the right tool for the job and maybe actually get some more work done. Well, more than usual, that is. Because time is ticking. Anyway, how is everyone doing today? How is the Wednesday treating you? Middle of the week, the woes and wares, the work week are starting to pile up, and yet again, the prospects of the weekend are also trying to shine a bit of light. So let me know what's going on with you. On the news and updates front, from my side, really not that much to report, really. I did put in the request for my annual leave for the World Cup, so here's hoping it'll be approved soon. And in the meantime, I'll just be taking away at these minis. Still, there should be enough time to finish them up, no matter how slow I paint. As long as I do it regularly, there shouldn't be an issue. And as we talked about it before, after that, and when I return from Dornburn, things should be on a, well, not that much of a different schedule, but there will be more diversity, more variety, less stress, and less of me nagging about time schedules and deadlines for finishing up projects. Which, for better or for worse, means that we will take much more time to do anything and everything, slowly, steadily, happily, hopefully. Hello, Pagan Space. A good evening to you. How are you doing? Anything new on the horizon? Oh, that's nice. Thank you. I'm fine as well. Can't complain. I mean, I can. Everyone can. All the time. But I choose not to. Yeah, I caught up on sleep. Getting better. Getting back to the work schedule. So still readapting after the vacation time. But it's getting better. Let me know if the music is too loud compared to my voice, because I did do some tweaks last time and I'm not really sure if it's manageable. Alright, let me know if anything comes up. Alright. That can easily be arranged. There we go. The camera has been playing a new set of tricks on me lately. As in, it just doesn't work. The image just breaks as I turn the thing on. Yeah, I mean, why keep to an established variety of issues where we can always have new ones? Thankfully, this one was an easy fix, but it has been happening almost every time now. Like ever from the first stream on Monday, it's been doing it every day. As usual, it doesn't appear to fix itself, so it may or may not get worse, but at least it's a quick fix. I just plug it out and plug it in again. The oldest trick in the book seems to work fine. But it's one more hassle to keep in mind. Either way, here's hoping that today I will actually be able to put on more than one color on these minis. So the idea being, finish up with the non-metallics, touch up the non-metallics so I don't need to change the water, because I'm lazy that way. Yeah, I know. That's already two things, which is twice as much. As usual, yeah, I know. But it is what it is. This is hopefully the very last batch of minis that I will paint in more than one mini at a time on stream. So in the future, I hope that they'll be able to do more progress on less minis. But again, that's future talk, so I'm gonna get into it that much. Let's get ready. Clean off of the brush shaping starch. Yeah, I suppose. As much as there is such a thing as a schedule. For the first time in three seasons that I've been playing in Rebel, my opponent contacted me first today. So hopefully he will let me know the exact time of our next match. It's probably gonna be on Monday again. They'll go up against the Bretonians. Did you have a chance to schedule your game yet? Oh, nice. This week's game. It's not it. Well, it should be. It's Wednesday. Oh, maybe there is, for ramp up. Okay. And that, there might be some games that are yet to be played. And they are waiting until the last moment. Since the games aren't scheduled in advance. Oh, there's a new coach in town. That'll make things interesting, as usual. Yeah, here's hoping. Did you see the shirts for the World Cup that are being printed? Yeah, I know what you mean. It feels a bit off when you're in ramp up. And with the new changes, it's a bit less likely to actually get promoted to a division mid-season. I think you're right. Being more representative and... But still, we will have our nicknames, and as far as I understand, the country on the sleeve will be updated. It'll be fine. Yeah. Shouldn't be much of a problem. Yeah, neither do I. Oh, that would be great. Yeah, okay. Gotta watch your back. So, onward. Can we still salvage this paint? I might actually have to get a new one, because this pot is broken a little bit. And the paint dries. No, not exactly. For some reason it can't close correctly. No matter how much paint I scrape off of it, it just won't close, which is weird. And as a result, the paint keeps drying. Use gum to seal it. Maybe that can help. Yeah, that's a good idea. But it has already started to dry pretty severely. Come to think of it, it might be... No, there's still liquidy stuff in it, but not that much. Maybe if I put a little bit of water into it. Great, now my dropper is out. Stuck. Yeah. Anyway, let's shake it a bit more, see if we can salvage anything. It's bad. It is bad. Oh well. Guess we will do some mixing. Because this appears to be absolutely out of commission. Well, that's a first. No worries. Since it is a mid-color, and I have both the base and the highlight, shouldn't be hard to get
the same color mixed up.
It'll just take a bit more time. So this will be a mix of the deepest, darkest brown I have. With the lightest one, because it appears that the higher you go up the highlight chain in the Citadel range, it appears that the mid colors are part of the lighter colors, which kind of defeats the purpose of mixing if you have the colors available, or the other way around, it defeats the purpose of having the mid colors if you have the two that are at the ends of both spectrums. But it is more along the lines of convenience, I guess, so it's fine. Well, so it appears. I'm not 100% sure, but... a few times I tried mixing, and that's what came out. Yeah, there it is. The exact color. And let's start off with the one that has more surface to paint. Hey there, MV Pettis. Thank you. It is always appreciated when you can drop by. Nothing too much on the front here. Just putting some more paint on the midis. How have you been doing? Hear that you might be getting a visitor sometime soon. As in, I think it was early October, was it? Yeah. I heard about the adventure with the location and the tickets. Nice. Well, you are probably, yeah, a little bit, turns out, but it's all taken care of, don't worry about it. So, yeah, I was about to say that you're probably the only person in chat right now who has been somewhat productive in his daily, so good for you, because I sure as hell haven't. Been mostly redundant work lately. Significant amount of it, but not productive in any way. Not effective or interesting. Oh well. Still, it's good that it has reached this point. Anything else new? Have you had time to play any games? Anything? Because this is the exact time and place to share all your nerdy accomplishments or experiences in general. The first one. Yeah, I suppose. Oh, okay. Oops. Well, that's a bit of a boast there. Keep it in your pants, dude.
seems to follow like a shadow, dark and cold to the touch.
Okay. Valid point. Yeah, actually, Fallout follows the same system as well. First one is actually sort of shortish, and the second one just blows all over the place. However, and also the story suffers, and cohesiveness suffers, at least for StarCraft and Fallout. Portal is just better, I think, the second one. And just flat better. Showed me today Blasphemy, which does look very interesting to play. It's one of those sort of old school 2D Castlevania-like, Metroidvania-like games with pretty decent looks, not so much emphasis on the retro aesthetic. So we might get around to playing it soon over a cup of coffee or something. Yeah, it's a new one. It is still retro-inspired and all that, but it's not as heavily pixelated. Yeah, exactly. It's kind of like Dead Cells, looks like kind of Dead Cells, but with less pixelation. Oh, dude. I don't know. I mean, Tyranny tries to put a new spin on an old formula, but I don't know. It was very hot when it came out, but I haven't heard anything about it ever since it came out, aside from a few Let's Plays. Oh, are you locked into playing a spellcaster? Do you not have the freedom to choose class and specification? Specialization, that is. It knows this, yeah. Oh, okay. Usually these games are much more fun playing as a spellcaster. And it's always been a bit of an experiment for me to try and see if they can make a sword and board character feel fun and entertaining, as opposed to something that grows so dull you want to slit your wrists out of boredom when you fight. And to be honest, on that front, very few games actually manage that. Like Divinity: Original Sin managed to do a interesting sword and board fighter. And talking pure RPGs, I think that's about it. Maybe Pillars. I think Pillars attempted something similarly. I don't know how much they developed it. I haven't really played the game, but I've seen the character creation and the skills, so it may actually be. Did it though? Like, I am talking plain sword and border, like soldier, warrior. So I'm not really sure it did good. I'm not talking about paladins or not even barbarians, because they do have a little bit of something up their sleeves with the whole rage stuff. But yeah, because sword and board is so straightforward to play, like tanky, not mid-level DPS style characters, it's very hard. It is objectively hard to design the rules around them to keep them interesting. But yeah, what was I talking about? Yeah. Also, you can always go for some weird feats of strength or agility that the game master would hate you for attempting, but it does open up a lot more than something fixed. However, over focusing on that might actually break the balance and interest for other classes. So it is a difficult task. I'm not saying that they're doing it on purpose or that the designers are being lazy or anything. It is objectively difficult. But again, Divinity did an awesome job on that front. At least Original Sin. Haven't played the second one yet. And the old ones were about as plain as you can get, because they weren't exactly this kind of game that we're talking about. They were more like puzzle games. Very, very badly explained puzzle games. And I was very angry that I couldn't get anywhere in them. But yeah, Original Sin really, really kicked it up a notch. Yeah, it does keep its price. Because of the multiplayer component, it's still relevant, and so it doesn't drop as abruptly as other games. By the way, playing it in multiplayer that game is amazing. With the whole in-game bickering mechanic with the rock, paper, scissors stuff. It really makes decision-making really fun and challenging, and it gives it an in-game stake. It's really cool. I really do have to try the second one once it gets a bit more humane in terms of price. But I see that you can actually play an undead character there, some weird races, I think a skeleton, a zombie, something along those lines. It's quite unusual, I think, for high fantasy games. I would offer myself, but first, I've already played it, and secondly, this will probably be a game per one sitting per, I don't know, month or two or five. It's gonna be... I actually don't think we were able to finish the first one. We got really close to the end, but never got around to push, to make the final push to finish it up. But it is great. Like, it's just a gem of a game. Yeah, I am. No, I mean the amount of times per month you can actually sit down to play it. Otherwise, yeah, it's a huge game. And also the combat mechanics with the elemental synergies, aping a little bit on Magicka. I really have very, very little bad things to say about that game. And I think the second one is again just flat better. From what I've seen, at least. Oh yeah, Magicka is in a league of its own. There is no denying that. Both, actually. Both are fun. Because the core mechanics are the same for both games. Sorry about that. Maybe refresh the stream. Because I'm keeping tabs on the performance and it seems to be stable on my side. Okay. All right. Hopefully it'll get back to normal. Don't know if you saw this from last time, but way things are going, I'll probably be playing Fallout next month. Like the first one, the original one. It's kind of leading. So if you have any interest in that, you might tag along for the ride. Thinking about some possibilities for character build. Whether I should make it just a whole stream, just making the character with everyone in chat, suggesting some wild stuff. For skill builds and whatnot. Would be absolutely insane and go for a pre-generated character. Because it feels a bit less roleplay when you fine-tune your character to be some sort of a very specialized, almost genetically engineered human. So going a bit crazier on the character build might be fun. I've already had a personal playthrough with the classic crit build. Starts off a little bit slow, but at the end of the game you're just a massacre machine. And while it is fun for a while, doesn't really make too much sense to be like that. But we'll see. Time will tell. Or maybe again through... No, I don't think a series of polls will help the situation much, because it'll just drag things out, and it'll be like a billion polls to set up a character. It'll probably be interaction with everyone in chat, and we'll build the character together. We'll talk about his general mode of operation, like is he a kind dude or girl, is he a murdering psycho, is he a smartass, things like that, and then we will try to roleplay him to the best of my abilities. Think that would be best, because it's not really a blind playthrough. I can't really pretend to not have ever touched the game in my life. I don't know it by heart, like I don't know every single nook and cranny about it, but still. I've played it enough. So it might be fun to screw around with it a little bit, or if I gotta be completely honest, it might actually be playing it as intended.
Cam is trying my patience again. As it does. Just gonna finish up painting these pigtails. And then I will reset the exposure settings. Please bear with me for a little while. And then I will make it better. Yeah, I think that's good enough. Let's restart the exposure. So there will be a quick second at which the screen will become very bright. So you may want to look away in 3, 2, 1. And done. Hopefully that... No, it doesn't. This camera. It'll be the death of me, I'm sure. What can I do? Put it up. Give it some gain, maybe. Happens to give it some gain. Backlight compensation? Yeah, let's go with backlight compensation for now. A bit better. Okay. Goody. Temporarily in the clear. Maybe. Yep. Sort of good. It has been a while. Since I've had to play around with the camera. And I did not miss it. No. Keep it where you were.
probably not the best place for a face cam either, but what you gonna do? Get some more light on me. Staying somewhat further back. Might not be seeing any of me. So, I just noticed that I will need to paint some fangs on the... whatchamacallit. So now it's too bright. Kill the backlight. Yeah, there we go. So, the claws on the pelt here. It'll just be a second's work. It needs to be done. And then I will do some touch-ups. Because I did go a bit crazy on some places, so I would like to do some patchwork changes. And then we are off to Metallics. It appears chat died a little bit, but that's alright. How are we doing on time? Decently. Let's see what we will start with. It probably was the last color was the brown. So there shouldn't be anything over the brown right now. So we can skip the brown and go to the blue. We have a few places to touch up the blue. The gray looks pretty fine here. And here is here it needs a bit of a touch up, and then finally the flesh. So just going the opposite way to which I started painting, so you can see it from left to right on the palette here. And this is, I suppose, a good rule of thumb to keep when doing touch-ups at this stage. You paint from the inside out when placing the base colors, and then you go reverse when doing the touch-ups. Which is, well, it makes sense because the color you laid on the mini last will have the least need for touch-ups. Unless you just didn't make a good coverage. And then for the metallics, I'll just need to go as neatly as possible and hopefully avoid the need of corrections altogether. We'll give it a shot, we'll see how it goes. Right, so, blue. I have this time prepared the paints I would use for this stream ahead of time. I would need to reach out to the paint box of sorts. It's actually the lid of a shoebox, if that makes any sense to you. But it's not exactly a paint rack. The preparation for what, dude? Get it out. Shaking the before the stream. Yeah, I just took them out and placed them here on the paint station. Because otherwise I need to do something like this and disappear from a frame, reaching into the shoebox lid. I think some cleanup is necessary here. I also try to put them in the sequence in which I will be using them. But that isn't always the case. Right, so. Where do we need to do touch-ups? Here, apparently. Horrible of a job as I initially thought. The other one
here. Yeah, this is a bit worse for wear, but nothing that cannot be amended. Good. Now, I did notice that I missed painting the sole of the boot on this mini. But I already have brown laid out on the palette. It's just simply going to use it. Maybe another coat once this one dries out, but until it does, we're gonna move ahead to the gray. Does the gray need the gunking? Yes, it does. Interesting that the gunk always piles up on the same side of the pot. I don't know if it's because of the pot or because I shake it from the same side every time. I don't know. Because otherwise the lids don't close well. And the paint dries out. It does, but going you still maintain a little bit of a better airtight condition, so not much air is coming in. I don't know which is better. But if it piles up too much, it does become unusable. Also, the lid starts sticking to the dried out paint, and it gets harder to clean up, to open the lid at all. Again, issues that people using dropper bottles do not experience. Maybe if I start slowly switching out the paints as they dry out, so instead of replacing them with another pot of Citadel, I go for a Vallejo or something else, and that way the transition will be more natural and I will only replace the ones that already are empty or dried. Considering that none of these paints are actually stocked at a physical store. Just in my paint collection. Yeah, I know. I'm just thinking out loud. Trying to think of a way to do it in a way that I won't actually need to completely forgo the use of paints I have, and at the same time do start a transition to another paint line. I can just bite the bullet, get another set of paints, and use them simultaneously, and then just don't restock the Citadel ones. I don't know. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, but doing it in a transitional way. So for instance, the paint that I was trying to use at the beginning of the stream that has dried out, I replace it with a close equivalent from, let's say, Vallejo or Scale 75, and do the same. But because neither of these ranges are sold in our physical stores, it means I have to order single paints, and that'll become way too expensive because they will have shipping. Anyway, it's not really a pressing matter in any way. Yeah, that's an option. But I do prefer to usually get just a collection or a piece of the a certain part of the range. But anyway, most of the paints are currently intact. It's only just the one that has dried out, and as you saw, it's easily replaceable with just a little bit of mixing. It's not a pressing matter. Okay, so that was the gray. Taking another look all over to see if we have any gray overlapping. We do not. And here we only have the pelt. And it appears to be... Oh, okay, here we go. And I'll do it.
Which brings us to the last step of touch-ups, which will be the flesh color. Starting to flicker again. Nope, not yet. The flesh will probably have the most for fixing up since it was the first color laid down, and so any other color that has had contact with it would have stained it. Yeah, that is from the automatic exposure. This is unavoidable, sadly. Because if I turn off the auto exposure, I can't. The manual settings don't give me what I want, so I have to rely an automatic, which will bring up this flickering. Never consider that this could be an issue as an before I started, that is. That it's just a small technical challenge. Up. Where have I messed up the flesh here? I think that's it. Here a little bit. Here we probably have some more. Thankfully, as I am still painting with base colors, their pigmentation is a lot stronger. Oh yeah, yeah, I was actually, I don't know if I put it in the poll. Yeah, I've
played a few hours of it a while back. It does take a little while to start getting interesting, but once it does, it's pretty great. I like it. I got the director's edition, so the one that does have a bit more quality of life improvements, because I recall that the original version of Wasteland 2 had way too many manual aspects to it that made it very tedious to play, that were addressed in the director's cut. I like it. It's at first I was a bit resisting to it because of the squad-based concept, because I don't really like having the first couple of missions are a bit dull because you don't really have access to anything. Once you go through them, however, it does open up and it becomes much more versatile, so you can have a lot more equipment, you unlock shops, you unlock different sources. It becomes a lot more open. The first it was a bit dull, but overall it's a very good game. Some things are a bit too old school for me, as in something that I really... that is an aspect to it. Yeah, in the beginning you don't really have much of anything, and it does take a while, so you do have to be sort of to manage your resources and be a bit more careful that way. But the one thing I didn't like about it was the perks system, and particularly the fact that you couldn't see how the perks are generated before you actually start the game. And in a game where you have to build yourself a squad, that's just unnecessary, because you do need the information. You need to know what are the prerequisites for the perks, so you can tailor your characters to it, because otherwise you're doing it a bit on the blind side for the first few times, and that's just annoying. Aside from that, I mean, the same goes for Fallout, but Fallout is from 1997. So you would think that notes would have been taken on that account. Either way, still a good game. And I was very close to starting it off again. And then I got the idea for this whole streaming and poll thing. And I decided that the viewers will choose and decide when this game will be played. And I think it is the only game in the poll that is essentially a sequel. But I think no one would really hate me if I didn't play the original Wasteland, because that's a little bit too much even for me. It's basically a text adventure. Oh really? Well, in that case it'll be in the next. Ah, yeah, because I wanted to keep it limited to Steam games, and the one, the version I have is from GOG. That may have been the reason. Just cleaning up my games library one at a time. And I decided to start off with Steam. Call it OCD. I don't know. And I did need to think of as many criteria for limiting the amount of games as I could, because otherwise it'd be way too many titles. Of course, I saw that I missed another thing. Is the guard, the arm guard here? Just completely forget. Paint the thing. Drying. Let's go for another coat of brown. For the sole of the boot, which I also forget to paint. It's funny, because I actually was thinking about this thing, and I was wondering whether or not I would forget to paint it. They do tend to leave out the soles for whatever reason. And I looked at the minis, and I saw this one, and I immediately assumed that I did it for the other mini as well. Which wasn't the case. And that is the story of that. Now another coat of blue. Thank you.
Yeah.
I try. Difficult trying to tell yourself to remember not to forget when you are actually prone to forgetfulness. And it gets really counterproductive. One of my professors in university, we were having this discussion, and he said, yeah, but if you are prone to forgetfulness anyway, even if you write it down on a sticky note and forget where you put the sticky note, then yeah, exactly. Essentially, the only solution to this is to train my mind and be a little bit more focused as I do stuff, and that is about it. Yeah, that's a possible workaround. Honestly, I would just prefer to train my brain to work a little bit better, because I have been experiencing an over-reliance on reminders and sticky notes and schedules and calendars. And my brain has started to rot a little bit, not having any stimulus to retain information anymore. It'll be fine. This looks way too light. There's Andrew dust. It is. Oh, so I'll just put another layer on top of it. We should be good to go. That ought to do it. It's a really weird detail to put here. I don't think any other model with this kind of belt had a paw. But maybe the sculptor's creative juices were running a bit dry at the point where he started designing these. They are distinctly less awesome than the rest of the line of minis. Compared to the rest, they do look a bit more generic. Still nice though. Oh, and on the topic of Wasteland, to go back to it, right now they are in development of Wasteland 3. And I can't seem to remember which one it was, but one of the big companies actually helps the funding, or has actually bought was it Brian Fargo in Exile? Was it in Exile Entertainment, or was it the other one? I keep forgetting. I think it was in Exile. Can't remember which one. Maybe it was Bethesda, but I might be mistaken. Either way, it's in development. There was a huge recruitment boost for the game, for developers. And I think that there are some trailers out, but I haven't really paid too much attention to them because I want to wait and see a more ready-to-go prototype. But yep, it is coming. Is the time for metallics. How are we doing on time? Plenty of it. Lovely. What are you talking about, third color? Look at what's happening here. So, flesh tone, gray, blue, brown, mix of brown, Xandri dust. Come on, it's been plenty of colors today. And don't tell anyone, but I am planning on a fourth. But just keep it between the two of us. Yes. Quite.
Is there anything else interesting going on the gaming front? I have lost touch a little bit. Surge 2 is coming out on September 24th. With game development and expected new games, things like that. So there's the Surge 2, but I don't think too many people care about it. Might just be me. Cyberpunk 2077 is coming out next year, so not really something useful for now. Nothing that much that is actually interesting to me, so maybe that Blasphemy thing will be fun. Granted, I only saw the trailer, and I'm making my assumptions only on a couple minutes of trailer footage. Yeah, but when, like, you can see how I'm caking up with stuff, and it wouldn't be fair with the polls and all. Like, the whole idea of them was to choose. It does definitely, but I don't know if that's how it works or if it works more along the lines of Dead Cells with multiple respawns and restarting the game. So a roguelike setting, or is it more like each game it's run. I know. I suffered through both seasons. Yeah. It really wasn't good. And the one that can be any competition for horrible adaptation is Devil May Cry into anime. They just made it unbelievably bad, where considering that they have so much material to work on and that it is essentially anime, how they don't, just don't, it's useless. They mangle the character, they, like, Dante is absolutely unrecognizable for some reason as a character, not on visual level, but as a character. He acts absolutely like nothing that you would expect him to, and the story is, well, at the end of the last episode I was wondering why was I watching this the whole time. Like, there was nothing, there was no suspense, nothing. Yeah, game adaptations for some reason into anime, even if they are Japanese games, they fail to hit the mark for whatever reason. The Full Moon Princess Shingetsu no Kihime, that was a good adaptation, but it's on a fighting game basis. I don't think I've watched that one. No, I mean into anime. Is there an anime for Tomb Raider? Tomb Raider? But yeah, no. Yeah. Yeah, it wasn't all that good. Though, to be honest, the story of the games and the character in the games isn't all that much developed. They tried to give her some backstory now with the recent games, but it's, at this point, it's so bland and overdone that it didn't really make any waves. The soundtrack from Korn was fun. Yeah, Korn have a I forget which song it was. It's featured on the soundtrack of the movie. Can't remember if it's the first or second one, really. It's not that. It doesn't matter. I think it's the second one. Yeah, we talked about it before they came here for a concert. But that is the Devil Cry for that was developed by Bungie. So the attempt of Capcom to release a Western-facing version of their IP, and it really wasn't well received. I personally liked the game. The DMC Devil May Cry, I personally liked it. But many of the purists didn't. And their reasons are valid, it's just that what they really wanted to see in that game is something that I really can do without. Oh, it was a fun reboot, all things considered. But yeah, Combi Christ did, I think, 2 or 3 songs for the game. Well, they didn't do them for the game, they just featured it in the game. And they played all of them on the concert, and it was awesome, and it was great, and I liked it very much. Haven't headbanged so hard in a hell of a while. Yeah, I thought that they were gonna do more of their new stuff. But they actually focused on the good stuff. The good stuff. The stuff that we know. The recognizable songs. I did some digging, and it turns out the dude actually has two other groups, two other bands, projects. I didn't really expect. So one being Icon of Coil, has the same frontman, and I forgot the third one.
did not know that prior. I don't really get singers and other musicians having multiple bands. But I suppose after a while you do want to experiment with your style and try other stuff. But they always are fairly similar. And that kind of defeats the purpose, if you ask me. For instance, Corey Taylor, at this point, it's very difficult to tell if a song is by Stone Sour or Slipknot. First albums, yeah, you can definitely tell the difference, because old Slipknot almost didn't have any clean sections, or very, very little. And Stone Sour was more melodic. But since then, Stone Sour hardened up and Slipknot mellowed out. And both bands right now sound fairly the same. Yeah, for other metal bands that really, really need to try something new, yeah. Yeah, I agree. That I agree with. Like, Rob Halford's features, and Ozzy, yeah. Rob Halford features in, Five Finger Death Punch in what was the other one? In This Moment also has a song. Black Wedding is amazing. Ozzy with Rob Zombie is an awesome song. Iron Head, if you've listened to it, it's pretty good. Yeah, I agree. Giving them a little bit of color and exposure like that is good. But they are just features. Although, yeah, Halford did have his own project. And so did Ozzy. Yeah, you're right. And now, Dee Snider from Twisted Sister has his own thing, but it's really not all that good, I sadly have to admit. I was really looking forward to his new stuff, because I do hold him in, for some reason I hold him in high regard. I think he kind of wasted an opportunity there. Oh, Gamma Ray are Halloween dudes. Really? That's why they sounded so familiar. I honestly didn't know that. The dude from Hammerfall also has. Yeah, the vocal from Hammerfall also has a side project. It was his own name, but damn me if I can remember. Is it Kans, Kunz? I don't know, something Northern. Yeah. Oh, of course, David Draymond from Disturbed has one album with his other band, Device. And the album is rocking hard. But again, it really doesn't give much diversity to what they were already doing. They made it the tiniest little bit more electronic, but otherwise I don't see a reason why it couldn't be with Disturbed. Some people will probably eat my head saying that, but again, not saying that it's a bad album. Quite the contrary. It's just not that different to justify a whole other project. Yeah, definitely. I agree. But again, it's the same case. Put them side to side. Put both bands, put Accept and UDO on shuffle. And if you don't know the songs, try to tell the bands apart. Maybe that's just because in this particular case, Udo is just such a memorable character and presence. That he has just typesetted himself so deeply. And that you wouldn't really want to see him in any other light. I don't know, it's a long, long topic to have. I'm glad that came about. Right, so this will all be golden. And here we have a bit more. Yeah, that's a good example. Although it is a bit weird because he didn't found Black Sabbath, unlike most of the other side projects that we've mentioned. So coming into it, he had to adapt to the sound that was already in the mix, rather than try and innovate himself. But still, that's right. Here is a good example of sounding completely different from what you usually do. And then again, you have after Rainbow, you have Heaven and Hell. Which is another one of Dio's projects. And it's sort of a mix between Rainbow and Black Sabbath with him as lead. And of course, for the Black Sabbath, you have the fact that the band has Tommy Wyomie, who is enormous ego, so trying to put anything new or different over his head, I don't think is possible. I mean, that's the dude who just stands up and says, I invented heavy metal. And that's quite a statement to make. It's not unfounded, but it's definitely not 100% accurate. Yeah, better, much better formed. Phil Anselmo also has several side projects, although again, he is one of those people that'll do the same thing forever, because that's essentially all he can. Can't remember his... Yeah. And with... arguably good reasoning. Then he was a down, and I don't remember. I think he had a third band, but I don't remember which one it was. And the rest of the surviving members of Pantera went into Hell Yeah, along with the vocalist from Mudvayne, and it made a bloody good band. Sadly, of course, now the other brother is also dead, so Hell Yeah is probably not gonna release anything new. And just as I was about to start really following them and looking what happens. I think it was heroin addiction that he caught from following an injury that he had on stage, injuring his lower back, I think. And to deal with the pain, he resorted to severe heroin abuse. I know. Yeah. But I mean, you're comparing dinosaurs to lizards, like to tiny little lizards. Okay, maybe moderately sized ones. Exactly, yeah, I know. That's what I meant too. Yeah. That was my point. And so would Ozzy, to be honest. In that train of thought.
Nope. Sorry. Completely forgot. You write it down, actually. Okay. Okay, yeah, I see. I'm getting a decent idea about what you're talking about. Yep, I'm just looking at some stuff in YouTube. He is bloodied up in almost every single picture. So I do think I get the idea. Indeed, indeed. I will give him a listen after the stream. No, no, just for the to see him in action, like scene presence. Yeah, that sounds like if it was I suppose he is in rather punk type, but yeah, it's pretty much the extreme of what shock rock was trying to do, and it's yeah, there was also an all-female band called Rock Bitch. You ever heard of it? And their performances were pretty much what you just... yeah, exactly. The same one, yeah. Yeah. So yeah, it's not an uncommon practice to resort to such scenic presence. I think it's good. It's colorful to have such crazy people on the stage. No. From what I heard, I didn't like any of it, although I think I only heard live shows. And as they emphasize only on... No, not in real life. I mean, I think they disbanded when I was 5, so it wouldn't make sense for me to have seen them live, but recordings of live shows. So no actual studio recording when they are trying to sing. So I can't say for sure if they're shit or not. Just on stage, as they emphasize too much on the extracurricular activities. It doesn't leave much room for actually making good music. Yeah, they were also a striking phenomenon. Within the rock scene. Yeah, they just took the concept of shock rock and took it to the absolute extreme. You know what Alice Cooper started out doing? As he himself explained, the name of this genre doesn't come from the music itself, it comes from the acts that are on stage and that he is aiming to shock the audience. And this is why, this is where the term shock rock came from. Because I always thought it was something to do with the music, but it's not. I do enjoy. Yeah, although I don't think that this was part of a stage performance. As far as I know, it was just an accident. Someone just threw a bat on stage, and him being in the state that he usually is, just reacted naturally to it. But yeah, that definitely stayed with him as a defining moment. And it was also used in, if you've seen one of the older Sandler. Yeah, it just happened, you know. That's what makes it so unique. One of the earlier Sandler movies called Little Nicky, of which I am quite fond, not just because of the name. It has a scene where Ozzy actually, he appears in the movie and the main bad guy turns into a bat and he bites his head off, so. Now it's in this movie as well. By the way, if you haven't seen it and want to watch some goofy heavy metal stuff, I would recommend Little Nicky. It has its charms here and there. Again, it's one of the older ones he has, so it's actually pretty decent, I think. Well, I think it's decent. Very few people would agree with me, but it does strike up a certain type of nostalgia that I'm very fond of. And as usual, it has a whole cavalcade of known actors. It's really silly, and it's an easy watch, let's just say it like that. Whether you like it or not, it's just easy to watch, and it's a fun way to fill out an hour and a half. I might actually rewatch it again after the stream now that I've said it out loud. Harvey Keitel is in the movie. He plays the devil. A really old comedian is in it, but I never got his name right, so I'm not even gonna attempt to remember it. Really? That's actually quite high. I expected it to be less. As I've mentioned before, I have a fondness for bad movies. So, giving me low scores on IMDb only riles me up. Yeah. Well, it is in essence a parody movie. It is a parody of heavy metal and a little bit of satanic mythology. So it is. If you look at it like that, then it would appear to be ranking quite highly within its own genre. Take that away as you will. Yeah, I confused this movie because as it came out, there were two parodies of 300. One was Meet the Spartans, and the other one was 301 or 306. It was a play on 300, but I can't remember the exact number.
And I watched both of them in the same day, and as a result, I am unable to tell them apart, but they were both horrible, so... you can take that for what it is, and... yeah, there is a slew of bad parodies. The ones for Twilight. Well, it was one, again, very similar. One was Vampires Suck, and the other one was Just Suck. The one was Twilight parody, and the other one was a vampire parody movie with Alice Cooper. Again, can't tell which one is which. But I would suppose that they are also in that category. Still not really complaining. Sometimes you do need a little bit of silly humor, as long as it actually is humor. I personally think Little Nicky does hit the spot in a way that Meet the Spartans does not. Well, which one? The other one. So, Just Suck. One of the two. Well, you didn't miss much. I only watched it because of Alice Cooper, and it didn't make up for it. Let's just say that. Right, so Silver Metallics are on as well. But I think I will leave the gold for next time. There are a few too many details to go over. With the gold on both models. So I would probably leave it for next time. Still though, it may be baby steps, but it's still forward. We are getting some stuff done, little by little. We crossed the line. Thinking about it, but there were some rather turbulent things during these days,
and I just couldn't really focus on it. And right now I kind of try to focus up on the minis. So I might, and also I do have the weekly game with Rebel. Hopefully, I don't know. Let's not make any, I'm not gonna make any estimations that I might not be able to adhere to. So once I get time, I'll just let you know, but don't really rely on me for any practice games for now. Sorry about that, just time is a bit short. What's the day? Today's the 11th. Yeah, I should really get some work into those models. Ah, yeah, well. I saw your post on Facebook today with the cake. Was very thematic. Right then, so that will be all from me for tonight. Some progress was made, and I think I'll do the same tomorrow. Keep things moving along one step at a time. Thanks everyone for joining in. Thank you, Big in Space, for staying with me until the end, and hopefully we will speak tomorrow. And until then, I have been Bachacolio, wishing you all a lovely night, to keep loving what you do, doing what you love, and I will now be signing out. Bye guys.